What's going on, guys? Blame Truth here, the Godfather himself, bringing you another video. And no, there's nothing wrong with your phone or your monitor or whatever. This is Halo gameplay. I'm rocking the sword and I'm rocking the ghost in these little clips. Now, theater mode is a bit glitchy in Halo, but other than that, I found no real bugs to speak of in Halo Infinite. I've been having a blast on it. And speaking of like the theater being bugged, I only got clips because of that. It's just glitchy. But I can forgive that one problem because the actual game functions. It's a functioning game outside of theater. So I'm just going to bring you some clips here. Before we get into the good news, and this is a good news day, I wanted to show you this ghost clip. And then after this ghost clip, I love splattering people. It's so great. I want to plug this particular commentary sponsor. This video is sponsored by Star Trek Fleet Command. It's a free-to-play mobile, open-world, strategic MMO available on iOS and Android. You can send your officers on missions, acquiring resources and developing new improvements all across space. There is a story-driven mission system across the multiverse, so you can enjoy thematic adventures. And the best part about this is there are monthly updates, so the rewards and the story are always fresh, new, and engaging. You can battle alongside your allies to capture territories, pool resources, and dominate the multiverse. You can earn renown among the Federation, Romulans, Klingons, Rogues, and Augments to unlock unique ships, characters, and more. You can unlock ship models and upgrade their equipment to find the perfect balance of powers. And these ships include the iconic models of the Enterprise-D, the USS Discovery, and the Klingon D4 class. You can unlock the iconic characters and pick your perfect crew to give your ship unique powers and combat ability. You can choose among Captain Kirk, Spock, and others to complete your crew. You can upgrade your space station to maximize your resources. And while you're at it, you can specialize your fleet with a wide range of research trees. And hey, if you're more about the open world experience, you can go to the neutral zone where you're independent. In the neutral zone, you get to play by your own rules. But I think the thing I like the most about Star Trek Fleet Command is how much it feels like Star Trek. I'm actually a huge Trekkie when it comes to the old series. I love William Shatner. I love Leonard Nimoy. And the original series has a special place in my heart. And this game lets me kind of relive that. And I love it. And guys, currently there's a Michael Burnham giveaway going on. If you reach level 5, you can unlock Origins Burnham. And if you reach level 10 by February 10th, 2022, you'll be given the shards to tier up your Origins Burnham to rank 2. Anyway, guys, visit the link in the video description to download Star Trek Fleet Command and let me know your experiences in the comments section below. And now I'm out. Beam me up, Scotty. Alright guys, back to the video here. So I have some very special legacy gameplay from Black Ops 3 because I failed at getting Modern Warfare 2 gameplay yesterday. I tried to play on PC, it was kind of dead, and then I didn't have IW4X installed, and then the one match I got into, after like 10 minutes of searching, because it's just a couple hundred people playing, it was just noob tubes. So I was like, yeah, let's just, I don't have time, I'm too busy with making videos, and too busy with like trying to play Halo Infinite and stuff, and in my spare time. It's just a lot going on right now. It's the holidays. It's busy. I'm trying to get a video out every day on YouTube. So anyway, I want to talk about something that's great though. I'm in a great mood because this is just phenomenal news, okay? So I woke up to this article right here. Literally unplayable. Warzone and Modern Warfare updates lead to mass uninstallations. That's a good sign. Honestly, it is. If you read the article, it just basically says how there's a lot of people on subreddit, on forums, on any sort of discussion of Call of Duty, Modern Warfare, Warzone, or otherwise, that are just sick of the problems and the bugs. And the article focuses on mainly Modern Warfare and Warzone in particular, but guys, it's everywhere. Like, the only working Call of Duty right now, and I say working as in it resembles a functioning game, I think is Cold War. And you guys know how I feel about that one. So, I thought about going back to Cold War. I played like one match. Without any events in that game, I mean, throw it in the fucking trash, man. I might get a physical copy of Cold War, actually, and just take it to bed with me so I can sleep easier. Fuck, like, NyQuil. Fuck sleeping pills. I'm just gonna cuddle up with Cold War and get a nice, deep sleep. God damn, that game is so boring. I can't get over how... Just look at this. Look at Black Ops 3, and then look at Cold War. I'm running around. I'm rushing around. I have a beautiful Dark Matter camo. Look how good this looks. It covers the whole gun. I earned this legitimately. You know, like, no SBMM. Fast-paced, colorful, beautiful game. Like, Black Ops 3, so underrated, just visually and gameplay-wise. One of my favorite entries, probably my second favorite Call of Duty of all time, behind Black Ops 2. Love this game. Felt it was pretty underrated when it came out. Loot boxes, notwithstanding. But anyway, that article came out, and you know, shat on Modern Warfare, shat on Warzone, showed all these people that are just sick of the bullshit. But wait, it gets better. It's not just the common man. It's not just the regular Joe Schmoes. No, sir. It is Aiden and Nick Merckx. So, Aiden says, losing my passion for Warzone and COD day by day. Shit sucks. And Nick Merckx says, Apex. Nick Merckx actually quit Warzone just to go to Apex, by the way. Pro League qualifiers in late February. Give you 2 months to prep. Your brain would love it. Just gotta give it a good shot. That or Halo. Big events. Hey, Halo. Mr. Adam AP and his company are bringing back that MLG experience. The game is great. You're the GOAT. Run it up. And normally this would just be considered like, you know, banter or whatever between pro players, big streamers, whatever. But check this out. Keeps going. Nick Merckx says, it would definitely be a vibe. Can confidently tell you that whatever Aiden decides to play, he will dominate. One of the best to ever touch a controller. Thanks for the gas, says Aiden. I'm probably going to play Apex a little and see how it goes. If I'm mispronouncing Aiden's name, it could be Aidan. Adun, I don't know. But if I am, forgive me. I don't really watch other people's content. That's not a knock on anybody else. I just don't have time. So I don't know how to actually say his name. But anyway, it's great news. The more like big names and pro players we get off Call of Duty, we get off Warzone, the better. Because the people playing those games are free advertisers. I mean, if you think about it, I'm a free advertiser for Vanguard in a way. But I definitely think I have done more harm than good. I have told you guys every step of the way, do not buy Vanguard, especially after this most recent patch. And it's so sad that you can't just buy a game, experience what it has to offer, and expect it to stay that quality thanks to these stupid fucking untested updates by Activision and their band of moron devs. I mean, look at Vanguard. It wasn't good, but there was like just enough Call of Duty feel into it to keep me playing. That's why I have so much stockpiled gameplay before season one. Then season one comes out. They add an incendiary grenade that shakes the screen every time it's thrown. They break aim assist. They add in more miscellaneous bugs and glitches. The game right now is unplayable. The aim assist thing, the incendiary grenade, just two of the dumbest decisions, the two perks they added, just bonehead bullshit. Like, honestly, I don't want to say this factually, but I think I'm just done with Vanguard. I think all the gameplay I have stockpiled will just have to last me until whenever, and then fuck it, man. I'll play something else. I'll play Halo Infinite. I'll play Viva Pinata. I'll play Peggle. I don't give a shit. Bjorn the Unicorn. Shout out to my boy. Seriously, though, I don't think I can go back to Vanguard. They'd have to fix a lot of shit. For one, aim assist. The fact that that's been bugged for 3 weeks now, nearly 3 weeks now, is absurd. I don't care if it's the holidays. How about you don't release an update that breaks the fucking game? I actually went back and I read Sledgehammer's letter to the players, or whatever the fuck it was, where they just basically said, oh, we made this game in a pandemic. Whoa, it's so good. Whoa. And they like sucked themselves off and sucked up to the community. Over 1,000 devs had a hand in making Vanguard. What the fuck is their excuse at this point? Is it a too many cooks in the kitchen scenario? Are they all just incompetent? Are they doing it on purpose? It hurts my brain just thinking about it, so I'm just not going to think about it, but guys, I'm out of time. I hope you enjoyed this video. Rate, comment, and subscribe. Ring that notification bell. I want to suplex Joe Sekot into the overpriced lumber at Home Depot. Peace.